Hello everyone, Argsy here. Welcome back to Elk Mountain Mining. We've just finished completing our application for our new mine permit. So we've put together a little bit of a plan, which you can see there shows the authorities how we're going to set up this new mine and where everything's going to be. So you can see the little green dot right in the center. That is where we set up the little sluice, the little stream sluice, and got that little bit of gold. Right up the very end, up in the top of the red, or the very right hand side of the red, about where we were doing our test pits and got all that gold out of, all that pay dirt out of, and managed to get some gold out of there and all cleaned up and into some bars. So you can see there, from there, the red areas are where we intend to mine. Then on the other side, the large flat area, we were going to put the wash plant down. We've got a settling pond planned, and I also figured we could actually set up a second gravel processing yard and take all the overburden, the stones and everything we're going to have to push off the top of the pay dirt. You saw last time there was some stones there, so we have to get in and do that, and I figured we could probably process some of that gravel and run it on down like we have over in the gravel mine. So all of that, obviously we need a yard and an access road there as well. We're going to have to put some bridges in just to make sure we protect those streams, so we're going to have to get some pipes in and figure out the best way to build some access across there. So that is the plan. That has all been submitted to the authorities now, so we're just going to have to wait and see what they come back with. Now, this isn't going to come cheap, so we do need to go and get started on some work and get some money rolling in again. So we're going to head down into the gold mine to start with and get everything back up and running. The mechanics have been working tirelessly on getting these trucks and everything serviced. They haven't even had time to clean them, but they are all back up and all fit and ready for the new season. So we're going to get these back down into the pit. We're going to get some pay dirt into them, get some dirt up here into the wash plant and get the gold underway. Then we will head on back over to the gravel mine because we can make some quick money out of that gravel getting it down to the trains. Now, with the new season, with spring, they have actually changed up the train arrangements. So we'll go down and have a look at that as well. But we have more capacity in the train now to take more product in the wagons, so that is something that's quite exciting, so we'll go and have a look at that as well. But first things first, let's get everything down here to the into the pit and get the gold mine back up and running. You can see everything is pretty much as it was left. Now we've still got the conveyors all set up, but we need to get some more dirt into them by the looks of things. They might have been able to pick up some of that dirt there in the middle, but it doesn't look like they have been able to. So we're going to get in and get everything turned on, set up and back underway to try and get some dirt loaded. I may even have a bit more of a plate in the excavator now. We've got quite a big platform and it is sitting up there a little bit precarious. Precariously. Bit of a tongue twister. So we'll go on first, though. We know we can get the dozer up and running and get some dirt pushed down pretty quickly with that. So we'll do that to make a start on start on some work here, and then we might go and have a quick little play in the excavator. I do just want to get this up and running and as much dirt moving as we can so that we know these trucks are going to keep moving and get the wash plant back up and running. So just need to make a couple of quick little changes to our terra farm and we will be off. Alright, so we're up and going here. We're starting to get a little bit of dirt over the edge, which is ideal. Should mean the conveyors will start. It looks like we might have to go down and get them turned back on so they can get up and running. Thought they would have been picking up that dirt from there. Maybe we were too far away. Maybe we've managed to get enough of this edge cut back, although we haven't actually moved the edge back, so there shouldn't be a problem. And we do know, if you remember, they were picking the dirt up from right up here on the top. So we'll go down, we'll go and see if we can get them back up and running and make a start there. All right, that's up and running. Got the conveyor here on the left going, but not the one on the right. I'm assuming we don't have anything in proximity for it to pick up, so I think you can see the excavator up there. We are going to go and hop up in that and see if we can get some dirt down here for this conveyor here on the left. We could always grab the big bucket excavator there and dump a load. I'm sure that would fill it up and keep it going for quite a while. But let's go up back up there to the excavator, and it's been a while since we've played in the excavator in the gold mine, so we're going to have a little bit of a play around with that. All right, well, we've managed to get ourselves a little bit tidier up. We were in a bit of a precarious position out here a minute ago, but let's see if we can go and get some dirt picked up here in the excavator. It's been a while since we've used the old joysticks and controls there, so let's just see if we can figure these back out, get it nice and smooth. There we go. Interesting to see if we can see that starting to go up the conveyor or not. Nothing there yet. We'll keep an eye on that down the bottom there. if we start getting some dirt discharging off that other conveyor, and that will be very helpful. Actually, there you go, you can see from this angle there is some dirt going up the conveyor there, so that's good. We'll just keep our concentration here, and we have to be careful we don't end up in a precarious position where we're going to end up with the excavator off the edge. It's been sitting here for a while, so we are going to be digging pretty close to it. But there we go, there is the first truck on its way back up to the gold plant. So I think if we spend a few more minutes doing this, making sure that we've got some dirt here in this right hand conveyor, and then we'll make sure that the bulldozer has left enough for the other side, and we will then be able to head on over to the gravel mine and start getting some gravel extraction back underway as well. Alright, well, I think that's about as far as I'm going to push my luck sitting out here. We've dug a decent amount out. Bit of fun getting back into the excavator and doing that. So we'll go and take a look. Looks like the trucks have got plenty still to go on with down there. We will spend just a little bit more time on the bulldozer, make sure we can keep that going for a little bit longer, and make sure that there's going to be plenty of dirt here. So when we do head back down to the gravel mine soon, that everything is still going strong. So let's just take a little peek here over the edge. There we go, there's a decent amount of dirt down the face there, which is good, and we'll get some down here for this one. So, bit of time on the bulldozer, and then we will be off to the gravel one. Well, we've got another whole lot of dirt pushed down here. It's getting a bit messy up the top, actually. It's getting a little bit hard to manage, but it's working out all right. We are keeping things moving, the trucks are running, the conveyors are keeping full, so that is the main thing. I think we're going to call it quits there down here in the mine for now. We'll go up and check that everything's running correctly up at the wash plant. I have no reason to think it shouldn't be. Make sure the tailings truck's going where it's meant to be. And then I think we'll grab, there's a couple of pallets of gold bars. We'll grab those from before we head down, and we'll sell those on the way through to the gravel mine. And this is the best way to get a ride back up out of the pit. Jump into one of the dump trucks here and ride up with that. So they're 100% full and are going to head on up on the auto drive course. You can see the other one is on its way down, so good timing. We'll follow this on up and make sure it all gets tipped out. No reason it shouldn't. It's done a couple of trips already, so we will go and just make sure everything else is going right. Tailings, there's not too much concentrate or anything like that we could get moved, but I think we do just want to get back over to the gravel mine as quick as we can, so we'll jump out up the top and make a move. Well, we've made it down this far, just getting around and in front of the dump point, so we should back up and get in there and get tipped out. We've actually got quite a bit of concentrate sitting there. I can see 7 pallets, which is good. The other thing is the tailings truck isn't here, so it's obviously off and taking a load down to the train station, so hopefully there's enough capacity in the silos down there. Otherwise we might have to again on our way to the gravel mine call past and double check that the train's okay, or we'll call the train in and get that unloaded so that there is enough space in the silo. But there we go, that is all working perfectly, so we'll just hop out here around in front very carefully and just go and double check the production. So there we go, we've got 66,000 liters of dirt. Diesel, 3,000 litres, that's plenty. 27,000 litres of tailings and almost another 1,000 litres of concentrate produced, which will give us 8 pallets. So that's good. Lots of gold being made. I like that. Now, we do still have to finish clearing this pond out at some stage too. We didn't get all the sand out of there, but it is running okay at the moment, so we can deal with that a little bit later. Let's head on up to the pickup. We'll go and get those couple of boxes of gold loaded up and head on down to the shop, get them sold, and check on everything at the train yard. There we go, we've got those two pallets of gold bars loaded up. Make sure we're going to strap those down nice and securely. We don't want them going anywhere. So let's head on down to the pawn shop. We're going to get these sold, and that'll top the coffers up just a little bit more and make sure that we're getting some income in. We are going to have to spend a lot on getting that second gold mine set up, I expect. It's not going to come cheap. We're down here at the pawn shop, getting backed in here with these couple of pallets of gold. There we go, must be in the trigger because it is going down and our money's going up. We'll wait and see how much we get here for 2,000 litres. $97,000, that's actually worth quite a lot. It's almost $50,000 a pallet at the moment. That price is fantastic. Let's just have a quick look. Well, there we are, looking at the pawn shop. We have got a high price at the moment, $48,000. I'm sure it was only about $36,000 last time. Price fluctuations, you can see $42,000 sort of the peak. Still leveling itself out. Where are we in the year? We're in April. We're about here. So we're actually experiencing quite a high at the moment. So that makes me think we need to get the rest of that concentrate we've got up at the gold mine over and into the washroom and get some more gold made, because that would be very nice to have as part of, we'll make some money off that. So something else to do. Right, let's carry on up to the gravel mine and get started on things up there. We're just coming up on the gravel mine now. We did catch up to the lime truck here in front of us, which is nice to see. It means that there has been lime being produced and running, but you can see everything else is pretty much shut down here, all out of stones. So we do need to go and get that up and going pretty quickly. We'll just let this guy get in and hopefully get another load of lime taken out. We'll park this out of the way because we don't want to be blocking any of the auto drive courses. I think we should be okay there. We'll just have to wait and see. And then we're going to go jump in the loader here and get everything up and going. All right, so we're down here in the Hitachi again, getting some stones dug and put into a pile there so that the conveyor can pick them up and load them into the trailers. Everything is up and running. We've got our workers sitting in the cabs over there, all ready to go. Be intrigued to see how the rock truck goes, because I know they're not the friendliest for what we're using it for, but it does seem to work. So we're just going to carry on here, get as many loads, I guess, put across there as we can, because we do want to maximise this, keep things moving, and we know we can make lots of money off this commodities down here. They are quite profitable for us, particularly the lime, but the sand, also once it's crushed and been through the crusher twice, not too bad either. So let's just carry on. We'll time-lapse here a little bit more loading. It's been lots of time-lapsing with loading and things today with the excavator and other things. But it's really what today is about, so we can get into the fun of building that new gravel mine next time. Assuming all our permissions come through, of course. Well, we've got quite a decent pile here now. I don't know how many thousands of litres there is in there, but I think it should be a decent amount to keep things up and going there. A few issues with this conveyor. The truck and the trailer didn't like driving under it. I don't know whether they're detecting a collision or something. I'm trying to think if there's a better way we could set this up to try and avoid that, but not that I can think of at the moment. But everything seems to be tipping pretty well. Run over here and have a look, because we probably need to turn the other truck on to get this one to tip out, because I imagine everything's full, isn't it? Does look like the case. Right, let's get this truck in here. In fact, looks like we might need to turn the conveyors on. There we go, we actually needed to turn the crushers on. Forgot that they actually needed to be up and running and activated to get some product going through them. So there we go, that should be all underway. Now we can see tipping down one end and the different products going through the line and ending up out in the truck. Perfect. Right, if we turn the auto drive course on here for this truck here then, they will be ready to go with sand back down to the train silo when they are all full. So hopefully we can keep on top of things there with that. There goes the lime truck off again with another load of lime down to the train. Perfect. Everything is going well there. Pop over here, the sand truck over this side. Can't be too far away from it leaving either. Getting pretty close to full. Oh, in fact, there we go. As we say that, out of sand or full? Must be full. So they're going to follow each other down to the down to the train, and we'll be able to make sure that everything else at this end is on top of it, that everything is being produced ready for them when they get back. This is the first lime truck back from the train silo. Things are still running here. We must be full of stones over in the lime crusher because the truck has stayed parked there. But that's a good thing because we have plenty of lime being produced. We want to keep the sand crushers and the gravel crusher going as much as we can though. So it means the tractor here can come and take another load through to the crushers, which is good. So we should see the sand truck get back in just a little bit. So I think we'll let them run just for a wee while, get this a little bit more lime, a little bit more sand, and then we'll go and load the train up and take that down to, or send that off on its way to the sell points. We've spent a bit more time here in the gravel mine. Things are up and running. Managed to get the tractor working out properly. I think we extended the conveyor and have a more height underneath it because of that. So I think that's helped a little bit. I'm not sure whether we're having more issues with this than the truck, and it might be something to do with the fact that the auto drive course that they use approaches it directly onto the end of the conveyor and probably picks up a collision there. So I wonder if we moved the conveyor over even to the other side, so it was after the tractor had sort of turned and gone underneath it, and then worked from that way, piled up the stones more against the side of the hill than against the top of the bank. Could be the solution, but there we go, it is working, so we can leave things running here for now. Now we are almost at a full train. We've almost got enough product down at the station, at the silos, to be full. So this truck here has been down and back a couple of times. So it got an 87% full, so it's not far away from going off again. And if we just come over this way, you can see the sand truck over there. You can see the dust, it is getting filled up as well, and it's already filling the trailer. So hopefully the front's full. Let's just check in here as well. It looks like it, 72%. So that should be all ready to go down again very soon. So I think we've missed our price. I was just checking, we've missed our gold high level price, so there's no rush now to get that concentrate that's up at the gold mine processed. We've missed the boat there with that $48,000. It's back down to 38, so 10 grand difference, which is a bit of a shame we've missed out there, but it is what it is. We'll just have to soldier on and make the most of what we've got, so we'll worry about that next time and see how we go. But I'm going to jump here into the pickup and put the gooseneck back on, and we're going to head down towards the train station and get things loaded up and off and sold. We're just getting pulled in down here at the train silo. We should be able to pull up and park on the outside here. We won't quite be in the way of the trucks. I think we've got a lime truck and a sand truck on its way down, and probably a tailings truck not too far away as well, I would have thought. So we'll go around and have a look at the train and go and see how it's set up and how full we've got it already. You can see we've already got some product in it, but the first thing you'll notice, a change from what we had last time, we've got six bulk wagons there. We've got the two identical, well, wheat ones at the front, we've got two bulk ones there in the middle, and I think the ones at the back are identified as sugar beet ones, but two more bulk there. So six bulk, and at the expense of a flat deck like a transport, and two of the logging wagons. So we made the change. Now it wasn't as straightforward as I thought. The train file, for anyone who's interested, the train file is defined in the map XML as a vehicle, or as a train type. There's actually an XML line in there, so I went in and changed that to the wagons I wanted, just changed the code for what wagon it was. But when I loaded that into the game, it wouldn't have changed. That's because this is a existing save game. I had to have a new save game for the effect to change. Once you're in a saved game, the settings for the train is actually saved in the vehicle file in your save game. So what I did to trick the game a little bit, not so much trick, but I loaded up a new save game with the altered train, got all the right lines of code into that save game file, and then I basically just copied those from the save game that I'd made into my existing save game here, and it all worked out safely and accurately. So we've now got the six wagons here, which was good. It was good to be able to solve it that way. there might be an easy way for it to have been done, but that's what worked out for me and was successful. Now, the one thing I would suggest, if you are going to be doing anything like that, make a backup of your save game before you do it, because you don't want to wreck that. But if we just jump up in here, we've got two wagons full of sand, 180,000 litres, 90,000 litres of tailings, there goes our sand truck, 240,000 litres of lime, and just the wagon at the very back still to be filled up. So I think, if we turn the train on here, pretty sure it's very hard to see, but you can see that that one there is full, and if we get the overloading option there for the sand. So if we just pull forward, these wagons are 90,000 litres each on the back. Let's just have a look and see what product we've got 90,000 of to put in here. So we don't actually have 90,000 litres of anything in the silos at the moment. We've got 64,000 litres of sand. That was after the sand truck had emptied out. Tab through here, go back the other way, we'll find that we do have 57,000 litres of tailings and 53,000 litres of limes. But what I did just check on the map is the tailing truck is not too far away. So if we just wait for a minute, we should get that in here. It has got enough to give us 90,000 litres of tailings, which will be good. So we'll let that get here, get emptied out, and we'll get filled up with the rest of the tailings and head on off to get this all sold. There it is. There is the tailings truck on its way through, and it should start dumping out in just a minute. All right, and there we are. We're getting filled up with tailings. I'm not sure if the truck's finished emptying out yet, but we're certainly able to fill it up. So we'll see how far we get with getting the second or the last trailer topped up. I did see the lime truck had just arrived too, so worst comes to the worst, we could always overload the tailings back out and top up with lime if that was the better option. And there we are, 100% full, 180,000 litres of tailings, which is perfect. So, no more space, let's head on off and go and see what we can make off this load. We've been averaging around 150 to 200,000 per train load, so it'll be interesting to see how high we can get on this one. We'll just click yes on our sell point and $360,000. So that is there's a fantastic income there, pushed us up to almost $1.5 million. And remember, we have got a lot of concentrate sitting up at the gold mine ready to go for next time. So that is a fantastic result, and it goes a long way to helping us get our new mine set up, assuming we get all the correct permissions in the future. Let's just have a look there. There we go, that is the lime truck pulling through and getting emptied out, so still gonna have more product that we can sell next time. So we're going to jump into the pickup, we're going to head on back up to the gold mine, and when we're back next time, next episode, we will be getting all that concentrate moved down to the washroom, getting that all cleaned up and turned into some gold bars, and hopefully our planning permission may have come through. Might be a little bit quick, considering it was only a couple of hours ago that we submitted it, but fingers crossed, who knows, the wheels might turn quickly in Wyoming. So as always, thank you all very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed that episode, and we'll catch you in the next one.